So welcome. In this video we will explain introduction to programming and flowcharts and algorithms and flowcharts. So who are preparing for TCS, smart hiring for BSc and BCA, take mock tests on student Canada co-writing from 25th December 2018 to 4th January 2019. We are providing 10 mock tests. Most of the questions are coming from these 10 mock tests. 50 to 65% of the questions, model questions, are coming from our mock tests. So take this opportunity. So regarding program, the definition of program: a program is a set of instructions that a computer follows in order to perform a particular task. This is a very simple definition. But going deeper, here machine can understand only zeros and ones. Human being cannot write zeros and ones in a continuous manner. It is also not possible to remember all the zeros and ones to write the program. So that the program is nothing but some human instructions. These instructions are converted into machine instructions by using compiler or interpreter, and finally we need to run the program. So while writing this, we need to know what is an algorithm. Before knowing the definition of algorithm, we need to know the introduction about algorithm. An algorithm, pronounced algorithm, is a procedure or formula for solving a problem. The word derives from the name of the mathematician Muhammad ibn Musa'la Qawasmi, who was part of the royal court in Baghdad and who lived from about 780 to 850. He worked the likely source for the word algebra as well. So the different definitions for algorithm: an algorithm may be defined as a finite sequence of steps, each of which is precise, unambiguous, and executable in finite time. An algorithm, second definition: an algorithm is a well-ordered collection of unambiguous and effectively computable operations that, when executed, produces a result and holds in a finite amount of time. Third definition: a step-by-step method of solving a problem or making decisions, as in making a diagnosis. In the fourth definition, an established mechanical procedure for solving certain mathematical problems. You can write any definition or you can explain any definition, that is no issue. And coming to the flowchart, these are the three definitions available. A flowchart is a diagram that uses graphic symbols to depict the nature and flow of the steps in a process. Another name of the flowchart is flow diagram. A flowchart is a pictorial representation of the flow of the steps in a program, people in an organization, or pages in a presentation. A flowchart is a visual mean to show a sequence of some activities. It shows the sequence depending on conditions. So now, how to become a good programmer? If you write a program, we need to follow these five steps: problem identification, analysis, coding, debugging, and implementation. If you want to become a good programmer, you need to spend the time in percentages, like problem identification 25%, analysis 45%, coding 10%, debugging 15%, and implementation for 5%. We need to know each and every term in a specific meaning. Problem identification. In the problem identification, we need to know the basic definitions, meanings, and formulas available in the section. It is also called as background details of a problem. If you understand this problem, then only we can go into the next stage, analysis. So I will take a simple example to understand this. If you are strong in a particular programming language like Java or .NET, and you are working in a software company and ABC bank is approaching your company to develop a software for that bank, so that the the team assigns you to implement it. Immediately you cannot start. Why? Because you don't know what is bank and how bank is functioning. So that what your job is to study how the bank is functioning, how to create an account, means types of accounts and how to create an account, what are the documents required for creating an account. After that, how the transactions are moving from one account to another account, how the loans are issued, what are the documents required and what are the eligibility required, and these things are checking as a portion of the development. And after getting these information, then only you can prepare a model for development. Okay, second part is analysis. In this analysis part, we need to identify all possible solutions and also identify the efficient solution for that particular problem. And we need to authenticate with the client. If he is satisfied with the solution, efficient solution, then we need to implement. If any modifications are required, we need to do in this process. If we approach it, if not completed the analysis part completely and we are moving to the coding section, if any modifications are required, again we need to redesign the entire program. It is very much difficult and more cost will be occurred, so that you have to spend more time on problem identification and analysis. And coming to this coding, you know the problem and you know the solution. Ultimately, using any one of the programming languages like C, C++, Java, .NET, PHP and MySQL, Python, Ruby and Rail, D, Haskell, Kotlin programming language to implement it. The variations are only semantic rules, nothing more. So there is no particular programming skills are required for solving it. If you know semantic rules and how to run a program is enough for solving it. But we are concentrating more on learning these programming languages like C, C++, Java, .NET, PHP and MySQL, Python, Ruby and Rail, Haskell, D, Kotlin. But it takes only 10% of time. We are not at all concentrating on problem identification and analysis, but that is the core part. If you are good in problem identification and analysis, in the less time you are becoming a team lead or project manager in the organization. In the next section is debugging. If any error occurred in the program, either logically or synthetically, we need to rectify in this debugging section. And in the debugging section, we need to run the program line by line. And what is the meaning of error? Error is nothing but difference between what we are expecting and what system generated is called an error, also called as bug. And finally, we completed the four stages. Obviously, we need to solve the final destination. We need to run the program. So, a small information. If you are a beginner, forget efficiency and start solving easier problems and learn algorithms very properly. So, regarding program, so take it as a problem and we need to write human instructions in C or CPP or Java or .NET or Perl or Python, any programming language, and those instructions are converted into machine instructions by using compilers, respective compilers. And finally, you solve the problem. This is the one way. If you add an algorithm or flowchart, the program will be looking like this. Problem for algorithm, it is a step-by-step process to solve a problem. For that, it is a flowchart. It is a sequential pictorial representation of an algorithm that can be represented in human instructions, and those instructions are converted into machine instructions and we need to solve it. Thank you.